Yo, so it's your boy Dragon back for another YouTube video, and today's video I'm basically gonna be showing you guys how I made this thumbnail. And this is a subscribe request video, so if you enjoy it, make sure you drop a like and subscribe. If you want to request a video, just DM me at nfdragon52@gmail.com. Email me, or you can DM me on Twitter at nfdragon52. But what I'm doing right now, I'm just cutting out the My Player screenshot, and I'll get back to you guys when I do the next step. Alright, so basically what I do right here, I just keep on cutting out. And to actually get done with the screenshot and finish the cutout, you can go look at my player cutout tutorial. But what you gotta do is you can right click on it, then you wanna make selection, and then you wanna hit OK and make sure your filter radius is 1. Right here, what I'm just doing is I'm cutting out the hair, and you can skip past the part if you want to, but I'm just showing you guys how to cut out because a lot of people do have problems with it still. But if, like I said, if you want to request the video, just email me, and I'm put my email in the comment section, or you can just DM me on Twitter, and I might make a tutorial on it. So the next thing I'm going to do is go to my blending options on my player after I get done setting up the background and stuff. And basically, when I go in there, I just, like you see me do, I get the marquee tool, cut out the background, go to my blending options, I add a drop shadow, and you can slow down the video if you want to. I also add an inner shadow on here after I get done messing with that, and I just turn to the color white. And mess with those settings for a little bit also. So I hit OK on that, and pretty sure next thing I do is open the celery pack. Now when I open the celery pack, what I basically come in here to get is the spinner wheel. And if you need to get this, you can just look it up on Google. But if you can't find it, just get a regular spinner wheel. Type in spinner wheel PG or whatever. PNG, but yeah, you can just type that in to find it, and I will drop some alternatives in the comment section for that also. So if you enjoyed the video so far, make sure you drop a like, and I would appreciate it if you subscribe. But basically what I'm about to do now is put NBA player face on the spinner wheel because it's supposed to be like a jump shot video. So I'm gonna let this play out, and I'll be back with you guys and explain some more. Now, I think I added 5 NBA players on here. Well, actually, yeah, I added 5 NBA players. And basically, what I did was I was just going to blending options and copying and pasting the blending options. And if you know how to do that, you just right click, then you go up, click copy, then right click on the other one, and you just paste it. If you need to learn any further information on that, you can just go to my other thumbnail tutorials I do all the time on there, or you can just look up the shortcuts I put in the comment section. But yeah, I just put these on here. And it's pretty simple, just look them up, cut out their face with the lasso tool like so. And I go to filter, mosaic, and if I pronounce that right, yeah, mosaic. And basically what I do is I just pixelate the images with that. So I add 2 more NBA players on each side, and I basically just follow the same process for all of these. So next thing I do is I just open up camera raw filter for my player, and I just turn up the whites, the blacks, and all this stuff right there. If you need to figure out how to do that better, you can just go look at my camera raw tutorial where I use Topaz Lab, Magic Bullet, all that good stuff. So yeah, you just look at that. And basically what I'm doing now is kind of just add like a darker shade around it with the brush tool, and you can just hit B on your keyboard, go to 2, turn the color black, and go around. And then I added hue and saturation, turn the color blue, the colorizer, got a tutorial on that. And then I add like a little modeler, like layer style, with the blend options, outer glow, linear dodge, inner glow, linear dodge, or inner shadow, it's up to you. But yeah, and you can just see what I'm doing. The video kind of going fast, so it's hard for me to explain. So if you need any extra like explanations, just DM me on Twitter. But you should be able to see what's going on. I just had the animate lines effect. If you need that, hit me up. And now I'm just trying out some new stuff. I don't think I actually added that to the thumbnail, but you can skip past this part if you want to. What I'm about to do now is actually cut out this MyPlayer screenshot. And if you need to know how to copy the image, you can just right click, copy the image from wherever you get it from, Twitter or whatever. So yeah, but I'm cutting it out with the pen tool, and you hit P on your keyboard, the shortcut to the pen tool. And if you need to like look at a better video on how to cut out, you can just go to my you can go to my YouTube channel, look that up. But yeah, I'm gonna keep that in the video. But I'm just cutting out the MyPlayer. See, I cut out his hair. Basically just cut around everything. But yeah, if you're enjoying the video so far, man, and you still watching right now, drop a like on the video right now. So yeah, just get that, cutting that out. And I also cut out the panel below him with like the stamina and stuff on it. So yeah, play shows and chill with honeys, all I do is shine, tour the world, ain't it funny, I'm one of a kind. All I do is rhyme, all I do is get this money, all I do is grind, play shows and chill with honeys, all I do is shine, tour the world, ain't it funny, I'm one of a kind. Alright, so basically what I do then is I get done cutting it out, and I change the color background with hue and saturation. And I think I actually changed up like the background color like a few times on here because I switch up the color a lot. But I just did blend options and kind of did outer glow and the inner shadow with linear dodge on both of those, just like I did the first one. And you can use my MyPlayer layer style because that's pretty much what it is. And I also added a drop shadow to it. So yeah, you see I added that right there. And right here I just have this text, and I'm going through which one I want to use on it. And it pretty much is simple from this point on in this tutorial, because once you get down cutting out the actual shooter, everything else gets kind of easy. So I'll just show y'all me putting the text on here and how I actually do it, if you wonder how I put my text on there. But this is just gonna be me showing how to do it.
Money, all I do is grind, play shows and chill with honeys, all I do is shine, tour the world, ain't it funny, I'm one of a kind. All I do is rhyme, all I do is get this money, all I do is grind, play shows and chill with honeys, all I do is shine, tour the world, ain't it funny.
All right, so basically right here I just add warp on it, and I actually did it to the 2K logo too. And to do that, I just, man, you just see how I do it, man. If you need help, just DM me, because I can't really explain it why the video going so quick. But I know I added a vibrance layer down there and kind of put up the saturation. Then I went around with the brush again, had it on black, put one on soft light, and then I put one on normal. I think you should be able to see. I can't really see that good, but yeah, I know I went around with the black brush, and I added a drop shadow on it. So yeah, but yeah, that's basically just how you do it. Add this little effect right here. I don't know if I actually kept the effect, but yeah, if you want to add that, you can. Just let me know what you need. And see, this is what I mean by I kept switching up the colors. Like, I actually took the color off of there, and I don't know if I put it back on there, but I know I took it off. And then I just got that from the celery pack. Now it is a pack with similar layer style, so if you need to, just let me know too. It's called the Yo Sizzle pack. I think I mentioned it on live screen, whatever. But finally got done, merged visible with all the layers or whatever. Then I'm just messing around the camera. I know I upped the saturation, I messed with D Hayes, all them settings right there. Basically what I showed in my camera raw filter tutorial. But yeah, if you enjoyed the video, man, it means a lot to me if you subscribe to the channel. And just a tip for any designer watching this video, like, don't copy the tutorial, like, bar for bar, as I should say. Don't do that. I mean, I don't really care if you do it, but just don't do it. Like, if you really want to improve in designing, you feel me? I'm just making these to help people out. I don't want people to copy, like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, just try to make it your own little wave or whatever when you make the design. But if you enjoyed the video, man, make sure you drop a like and subscribe. And I'm just making these tutorials to help people out. You feel me? So don't come over here hang, saying I'm doing whatever. But yeah, if you enjoyed the video, man, I appreciate you watching to the end. Peace out.